Earlier this year, Apple announced the number of active in-use iPhones has risen to over a billion for the first time. Pretty cool, until you remember, one day they'll all need disposing of. So today we're asking, what does Apple do with old iPhones? In 2013, it dawned on Apple that it had a problem. Having adroitly dropped a glossy new iPhone every couple of years since 2007, most folks, in developed nations at least, had an iPhone, if they wanted one. The iPhones these folks had, moreover, worked just fine. And unless something went seriously wrong, they often didn't feel like upgrading. Faced with its first dip in profits for some years, Apple decided to offer a trade-in option. This meant, and still means, consumers can bring their old iPhone back to the Apple Store and receive store credit against the price of a younger, sleeker model. If the returned phone happens to be in good condition, Apple slips the consumer a voucher before whisking their old device away to a refurbishment center. From there, the device will be repackaged and resold, typically to vendors in emerging markets like India or Africa. That's a stroke of genius on Apple's part. Why? Because Apple is quite literally selling the same device twice. To be clear, that's only if the iPhone is still in saleable condition. If the device isn't in such good shape, the customer gets nothing and the phone gets recycled. How? With a little help from Daisy the robot. Capable of deftly dismantling 200 phones an hour across 15 distinct iPhone models, Daisy the robot lives and works in a nondescript building on the outskirts of Austin, Texas. Daisy is so sustainable, she's actually manufactured from the recycled components of a previous dismantling droid named Liam. Daisy's robotic arm is capable of extracting as much gold from 1 ton of iPhones as a regular miner would get from 150 tons of ore. Other useful materials recovered by recycling in this way include precious cobalt from the battery, copper from the camera, and silver and platinum from the main logic board. Apple could be more sustainable still, reselling intact components like cameras and screens for non-mobile applications, such as those touchscreens in New York taxis. However, the brand-conscious Cupertino giant can't stomach the idea of a black market appearing in bootleg or counterfeit devices, cobbled together from old Apple components. All Apple components are thus shredded, their logos meticulously removed. Once all valuable metals are extracted, the hazardous waste is shipped to specialist facilities like the Litong plant in Yangmen, China. Any remaining usable material is reincarnated as aluminium for stuff like furniture, or indeed as the shell of the new gen MacBook Air. Obviously, not every iPhone around the world can be shipped to Austin for a date with Daisy, so the process is licensed and subcontracted out around the world, to firms like Litong in Hong Kong. Litong specializes in so-called post-industrial recovery and post-consumer recycling, basically clearing up that which is very tricky to clear up. So Apple does its best to extract value from your old iPhone, whether by selling it to a less fussy third party or recycling its precious resources back into raw materials for new products. What do you think? Is Apple doing enough to compensate for the environmental impact of its FOMO-inducing hardware? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more carefully recycled tech content.